Thank you. Peace be with all of you, brothers and sisters in Christ. 弟兄姐妹，主内平安。So glad to see all of us gather here once again in BBC Online Worship Service. 很高兴能够再次的在这个北海浸信教会的线上崇拜中看到大家。Before we start our worship, let us spend some moment of time to quiet our hearts. 在我们还没有开始我们的敬拜赞美之前，让我们先花一段时间来安静我们自己的心。Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His love endures forever. 你们要称谢耶和华，因他本为善，他的慈爱永远长存。 是的，无论发生什么事情，我们都要来感谢我们的主。Yes, no matter any times, we need to give thanks to our Lord.
Thank you.
现在是收奉献的时间。You can give your tithes and other offerings directly into our bank account through online banking using the following details. 您可以透过网上银行服务将您的十一奉献或其他奉献转至我们的户口。银行资料如下。Let us pray for the offering with the Lord's Prayer. 让我们一起用主祷文来为奉献做祷告。Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. And forgive our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. 我们在天上的父，愿人都尊你的名为圣。愿你的国降临，愿你的旨意行在地上，如同行在天上。我们日用的饮食，今日赐给我们。免我们的债，如同我们免了人的债。不叫我们遇见试探，救我们脱离凶恶。因为国度权柄荣耀全是你的，直到永远。 Amen. Let us pass our time to Reverend Mark for the words of God. 让我们把接下来的时间交给麦牧师来传讲神的话语。
各位弟兄姊妹平安。
Good morning, brothers and sisters.
最近在我们国家有好些政治人物，有官司，有诉讼的案件。
Recently, there have been many politicians lawsuit in our country.
其中最热门的就是我们的前首相涉及滥权被判罪成的那个案件。
The most popular of which is the former prime minister convictions of for abuse of power.
通常在法庭上，控辩双方都有发言权。
The prosecution and defense usually have a say in court.
控方要证明嫌疑犯有罪，辩方要证明嫌疑犯没有罪。
The prosecution must prove that the suspect is guilty and the defense must prove that the suspect is not guilty.
那检控官呢和辩护律师呢都会盘问那个嫌犯、证人还有出示证据。来证明这个嫌犯是有罪还是无辜的。
Prosecutor and defense lawyer will cross-examine suspect witnesses and produce evidence to prove whether the suspect is guilty or innocent.
控辩双方都会为自己的立场来到法院。
Both of the prosecution and defense will speak for their own position.
最后呢？法官呢就会做出判决。
In the end, the judge will make a verdict on the case.
如果给你选择，你要做控方呢，还是辩方，还是嫌犯呢，或者被告
？If you are given a choice, will you be the prosecutor or the defense or the suspect?
在现实生活中。其实我们都会扮演这些角色。
In real life, we play all these roles.
有时候我们会控告人，给我们所控告的人下判决，判他有罪。
Sometimes we will excuse someone, give a sentence to the person we are accusing, and convict him or her.
但是有时会颠倒过来，我们被人控告。那个时候我们就会想要尽力的去证明我们是清白的。
But sometimes it is turned upside down and be accused. Then we will try our best to prove that we are innocent.
但是最糟糕的是，就是没有证据证明我们有罪，也没有证据证明我们是清白的。
The worst time is when there is no evidence to prove that we are guilty and there is no evidence to prove that we are innocent.
这个是最糟糕的事，因为这个是叫做含冤莫白，因为所有的人都认定你有罪，而你又没有办法证明你自己是清白的。
This is the worst thing. You just can't say you are innocent because in the perception, people consider you are the guilty one, and you have no way to prove that you are innocent.
我们应该怎么办呢？
What should we do?
在圣经的撒迦利亚书第三章就有类似的情况。
There's a similar situation in the third chapter of Zechariah in the Bible.
那就在这里这一段的经文那边讲，天使指给我看，大祭司耶稣亚大祭司站在耶和华的使者面前，撒旦站在耶稣亚的右边控告他。
Verse 1, then he showed me Joshua the high priest standing before the angel of the Lord, the Satan standing on his right side to accuse him.
我们一起祷告。
Let us pray.
亲爱主，我们谢谢你。Godfather, we just want to thank you. 因为是的，很多时候我们在现实生活里面，我们会遇到被人指控。Yes, Lord. In fact, in real life, we sometimes facing persecution. Sometimes we facing accusation. 也有些时候我们也指控人， but sometimes we also persecute others. We accuse people.所以主啊，我们祈求你就在这时候透过你的话语来教导我们。 Father God, we just want to pray for you. You teach us through your Bible. 让我们知道我们怎样来到实践你的旨意， so that we may know how to do your will. 我们把一下时间恭敬地仰望你， We commit the rest of time to you. 奉耶稣基督的名祷告， In the nameOf our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. In here, 刚才那段经，这段经文就是在撒迦利亚书第三章第一节那边，让我们看到天上法院的那一幕。
Here is the scene of the heavenly court.
撒旦就是那个检控官，而大祭司约书亚呢，就是被告。
Satan was the persecutor and the high priest was the defendant.
Satan 站在耶稣亚的右边控告他。
Satan standing at his right side to accuse him.
右边就是表明撒旦是检控官。
Right side indicates that Satan is the prosecutor.
他拿着罪证来控告人。
It accuses people with evidence. Evidence.
撒旦这个意思，撒旦他的这个名字有一个意思，就是敌对者。
Satan means adversary.
所以其实任何人都可以是撒旦。
So anyone can play the role of Satan.
只要你站在敌对的立场上去控告人，你其实就是扮演撒旦的角色。
As long as you stand at the side opposition to accuse someone, you are playing the role of Satan.
耶稣亚穿着污秽的衣服站在那使者面前。
Now Joshua was dressed in filthy clothes and he stood before the angels.
那个污秽的衣服呢，就是表示不是指一般的污秽，而是在原文暗示他 是穿着充满就是沾满了人的粪便和呕吐的那个衣服。
Filthy clothes. These clothes are more than merely soil. The origin text connot he was wearing clothes stained with human excrement and vomit.
这件超肮脏的衣服就是象征罪。
These extremely dirty clothes symbolize sin.
在这里显示大祭司耶稣亚本身有可能被就是有那些可以被控告的那些过犯。
It's shown here that the priest, a high priest Joshua himself has an excusable offense.
而且这个是相当严重的罪，因为这个超肮脏的衣服就暗示着这个是相当严重的罪行。
And it's quite serious, the extremely dirty clothes signify a serious sin.
因此他就引发人对他的控告。
So people came to accuse him.
但是在撒迦利亚书第三章第二节有一个异常的情形。
Zechariah chapter 3 verse 2 describe an abnormal scene.
这个就是讲到耶和华向撒旦说，撒旦啊，耶和华责备你，拣选耶路撒冷的耶和华责备你，这不是从火中抽出来的一根柴吗？
The Lord said to Satan, The Lord rebuke you, Satan. The Lord who has chosen Jerusalem rebuke you. Is not this man a burning stick snatched from the fire?
这个异常的镜头，这异常的那个情形，就好像一个异常的镜头那样子。上帝在这里竟然指责那个检控官，而且他撤销他对耶稣亚的那个控告。
God even accused the prosecutor and dropped its accusation against Joshua.
这是什么情况呢？
What happening here?
这里你可以看到，在经文上写到，拣选耶路撒冷的耶和华责备你。
The Lord who has chosen Jerusalem implies that the high priest Joshua was chosen by God.
就上帝好像在这里讲，他是我选的，你凭什么控告他？
I have chosen him. How dare you accuse him?
这不是从火中抽出来的一根柴吗？
Is not this man a burning stick snatched from the fire?
这个是有个背景的，因为当时犹太人经历了亡国，甚至被掳到异国他乡，现在回来了，这个是好像劝后余生的一情，就是代表着这个从火中抽出来的一根柴那样。
At that time, the Jews experienced national destructions and were even taken into exile to a foreign country. Now they are back and they are a group of remnant, just like a burning stick snatched from the fire.
所以上帝就在这里指责控告耶稣亚的人和撒旦。其实他好像这样想，他已经得到他应得的惩罚，你还控告他吗？
God is here to accusing the accuser of Joshua and Satan. He has received his due punishment and you still accuse him?
不单单这样，在第四和第五节还有进一步的行动。
Not only that, there are further action in verse 4 and 5.
第四节这样说，使者吩咐那势力在他面前的说， 脱去他污秽的衣服，又对耶稣要说：“你看，我使你的罪孽离开你，要给你穿上华美的衣服。”我说：“要将洁净的冠冕戴在他头上。”他们就把洁净的冠冕戴在他头上，给他穿上华美的衣服。耶和华的使者在旁边站立。
The angel said to those who were standing before him, "Take off his filthy clothes." Then he said to Joshua, "See, I have taken away your sin, and I will put fine garment on you." Then I said, "Put a clean turban on his head." So they put a clean turban on his head and clothed him while the angel of the Lord stood by.
天使命令在耶稣亚面前的那些使者脱去他的脏衣服，换上华美的衣服。
The angel ordered the messenger in front of Joshua to take off his dirty clothes and put on fine garments.
这个华美的衣服可以被翻译为过节的服装，所以在这里就有庆祝的意思。
Fine garment can be translated as festive apparel, carrying the celebration implications.
到底庆祝什么呢？就是庆祝罪得到赦免，使到他可以重新站在上帝面前来侍奉他。
There is a celebration of the forgiveness of sin and the qualification to serve before the Lord again.
而先知又在这里宣告，要把干净的帽子戴在耶稣亚的头上。
The prophet hereby announced to put a clean hat on Joshua's head.
这个代表耶稣亚这大祭司已经从头到脚都洁净了。
This signifies that he was completely clean.
他的罪完全被上帝赦免了，谁还可以控告他呢？
His sin was completely forgiven by God. Who can accuse him again?
接下去在第六节、第七节，上帝给耶稣亚一个劝告。
Next, God gave Joshua advice in verse 6 and 7a.
第六节，耶和华的使者告诫耶稣亚说：“万军之耶和华如此说，你若遵行我的道，谨守我的命令。”
The angel of the Lord gave this charge to Joshua. This is what the Lord Almighty says: If you will walk in obedience to me and keep my requirement,
就是劝诫他遵守上帝的吩咐和命令。
To urge him observe and obey God's commands.
如果他有守到这上帝的话的话，就会有这个写在接下去的经文，就是第七节 B 到第十节的五个结果。
If he would observe and obey God's command, there will be these five results which are written in Zechariah chapter 3, verse 7b to 10.
就可以管理我的家，看守我的宴仪，我也要使你在这些私立的人中间来往。耶稣亚大祭司啊，你和坐在你面前的同伴都要听，因为他们是做义造的。看啊，我必使我仆人大卫的苗裔长出。看啊，这是我在耶稣亚面前所立的石头，这一块石头上有气眼。看啊，我要亲自雕刻这石头，并在一日之间除掉这地的罪孽。这是万军之耶和华说的。在那日，你们个人要请邻舍坐在葡萄树和无花果树下。这是万军之耶和华说的。
Then you will govern my house and have charge of my courts, and I will give you a place among these standing here. Listen, High Priest Joshua, you and your
associates
sit before you, who are men symbolic of things to come. I'm going to bring my servant the branch. See the stone I have set in front of Joshua. There are seven eyes on the one stone, and I will engrave in inscriptions on it, says the Lord Almighty, and I will remove the sin of this land in a single day, in that each of you will invite our neighbor to sit under your vine and fig trees, declare the Lord Almighty.
这里就是有讲到，就是在这里说，就说他管理神的家，第一个结果。
Governing God's house。
这个是在写在第七节的中，第七节中，就是7b。
This is in 7b。
然后第二个结果就是他的神身份得到提升。
Second is position promotion。
就是在第七节 c。
This is in 7c。
在这里是讲到他可以在上帝面前的施力者中间往来，你看他身份已经提高了。
This is having a place among those who stand before God. See everyone's position is get higher.
第三，就是兴盛的应许。
The third is prosperity.Promise of prosperity.
然后这个是记载在第八节，就第八节那边讲到那个大卫的育苗，那个就是指到那个代表说他会兴盛起来。
Meaning of the branch in verse 8.
这个育苗会发生，就表示它是兴盛的。So it's comes to prosperity. 然后。第四个结果呢，就是陶造和除罪。
The fourth is continue to be more and remove of sin.
这个是第九节的那个意思，上帝会继续的陶造他和除掉他的罪。So this is actually Connors in verse 9, the Lord will continue to mold him and remove his sin. 然后第五。安全和平安。
Fifth, security and peace.
这个就是在第十节所记载的那个景象。
This scene described in verse 10.
让大家躺在那个葡萄树、无花果树下，是那么的安全，那么的平安。People just lay down on the fig tree and on the olive tree and also under the olive tree and also the vineyard. It symbolizes security and peace.今天我们也是一样，如果我们有遵守上帝的道，我们就可以管理上帝的家。
Today also the same, if we obey the Lord, the words of God, we can govern God's house.
我们也能够有上帝仆人的身份。
At the post of God's servant.
我们也能够得到上帝所赐的丰富。
Have the riches from God.
我们也能够得到上帝继续陶造和除掉我们的罪。
Be continuously mold and remove of sin.
然后我们也能够得到安全和平安。
Have security and peace.
所以这做总结。
In conclusion.
我觉得第一，我们不要控告人。我们不要做撒旦，我们不要去控告人，因为你控告人就是做了撒旦。
First, we should not accuse others. We should not act like Satan.
第二，如果你被控告的话，不要怕被控告。
Second, let us not be afraid to be accused.
因为上帝一定会为我们出头的。
Because God will definitely help us.
第三，我们要继续遵守。上帝的话。
Third, we have to continue observing God's word.
就能够得到上帝所赐的丰富，和得到上帝的陶造和除，哎，对不起， 就能够我们就能够管理上帝的家，也能够在他面前侍奉他。
Because he would govern God's house and to serve before him.
也能够得到上帝所赐的丰富和得到上帝的陶造与赎罪。
And also receive the riches from God and his molding and removals of sins.
并且能够享受到从上帝那里来的平安和安全。
And enjoy the safety and peace from God.
让我们一起祷告。
Let us pray.
亲爱主，我们谢谢你 ，Father God, we just want to thank you. 帮助我们主，帮助我们不要像撒旦 ，Help us, Lord, that we will not act like Satan. 喜欢去控告人 ，like to accuse people. 我们实在是没有权去控告人。Indeed, we do not have the right to accuse people, 因为我们控告人的时候。就是控告那有上帝形象的人。If we accuse people, we actually accuse the image of God, accusing you, because you, we are made before you. 主啊，我们就祈求你也帮助我们，在面对控告的时候，我们不要惧怕。Lord, we also want to ask that you help us that we, when you face accusation, we will not be afraid.Because we know that you will be with us. 因为我们知道你与我们同在。也帮助我们甚至在不管在任何情形之下我们都继续遵守你的话。So Lord, help us. No matter we are in difficult situation or in an easy time, help us continue to observing your word.So, 主啊，帮助我们，我们让我们能够不管在任何情形之下都谨守遵行你的话，使到我们能够得到主你的赐福。 So that we can receive your blessing. 我们可以管理你的家，可以在你面前侍奉他，可以在你面前侍奉你。 So that we can govern your house and to serve you.我们也同时能够得到主你所赐给我们的丰富。We also can receive the riches from you. 我们也能够得到主你继续在我们生命的陶造。We also can experience the continuous molding in our life. So that we can make perfect before you. 使到我们可以成为完全。And also we can experience the removal of sin. 我们也可以经历到主你在我们身上除罪，使到我们可以在人面前无可指责 ，so that we can be spotless before you， 也能够享受从你那里来的安全和平安 ，and we also can enjoy the safety and peace from you。感谢主 ，Thank you, Father。奉耶稣基督的名祷告 ，We pray all this in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
为了更新心中的方向，那惧怕路长，停下，让我知道你是神，让我倾听恩主的心意，引导我方向。只要时时学懂等候，明天会继续变。你带领仍旧会看顾每一天，心愿在你手里，驱走我心挂虑，无需为自己抱不平，只要默然祷告。心愿在你手里，困境从头面对，让每颗心换来真爱，从此有祝福藏梦里。 要走更远路程，为了更新心中的方向，那惧怕路长，停下，让我知道你是神，让我倾听恩主的心意，引导我方向。只要时时学懂等候，明天会继续变，你大能仍旧会看顾每一天。深渊在你手里，驱走我心挂虑，无需为自己抱不平，只要默然祷告。深渊在你手里，困境从头面对，让每颗心换来真爱，从此有祝福藏梦里。深渊在你手里，驱走满心挂虑，无需为自己抱不平，只要默然祷告。深渊在你手里，困境从头面对，让每颗心换来真爱，从此有祝福藏梦里。
Please turn with me to the Gospel of Mark, chapter 14, verses 22 through 25. 请大家翻开圣经到马可福音第14章22节到25节。找到后，请中文的先念。The Chinese shall read first. 请。他们吃的时候，耶稣拿起饼来，祝福了，就掰开，递给他们，说：“你们拿去，这是我的身体。”他又拿起杯来，祝谢了，递给他们，他们都喝了。耶稣对他们说：“这是我立约的血，为多人流出来的。我实在告诉你们，我不再喝这葡萄汁，直到我在上帝的国里和新的那日子。 English. While they were eating, Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, this is my body.Then he took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and they all drank from it. This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many, he said to them. Truly I tell you, I will not drink again from the fruit of the vine until that day.When I drink it new in the kingdom of God. Let us give thanks for the cup. Let us give thanks for the bread. Father God, we just want to thank you. Thank you that you have given us your Son, Jesus Christ. 天父，我们感谢你，因为你赐给我们你的儿子，你的独生爱子，耶稣基督。And he was crucified on the cross. 他被钉在十字架 for the atonement of our sin. 为的是我们的罪。亲爱主啊，我们祈求你让我们 知道你是为我们舍弃生命。Lord Jesus, remind us again that you have laid your life for us. Let us, at this time, prepare ourselves to eat your meal. Let us prepare ourselves for the Lord's Supper. And as we add and drink, we remember you have laid your life for us. 主啊，当我们在守餐的时候，让我们记得是你为我们而死。帮助我们能够谨记着主你为我们所做的。Let us continue to remind us what you have done for us. Thank you in Jesus' name. 奉耶稣基督的名祷告。Amen. Jesus Christ said, This is my body I lay down for you. Let us take this bread for the remembrance of our Lord. 让我们一起吃这饼来纪念主。Let us give thanks for the cup.让我们为这杯做祝谢的祷告。Lord Jesus, we thank you that you have laid your life for us. 主耶稣，我们谢谢你，因为你为我们舍命。And you shed your blood. 你流出你的宝血。你立下了新的约。And you establish the new covenant. And that we can enter into your kingdom to be the children of God. 直到我们可以进入天国，成为上帝的儿女。We want to give thanks. 我们要感谢。For what you have done. 因着你所做的一切。让我们警醒等候你的再来。And let us be watchful and be alert to wait upon your second coming. 奉耶稣基督的名祷告。In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. 让我们一起喝这杯来纪念主。Let's drink this cup for the remembrance of our Lord.我们一起祷告 ，Let us pray。天父 ，Our Heavenly Father， 谢谢你 ，Thank you， 因为你舍下你的爱子为了我们 ，And that you have given us your only begotten Son。And now, we want to continue to be watchful and alert. 我们现在要继续的警醒等候。Help us to live a holy life. 帮助我们过圣洁的生活。So that when you come, 直到你再来的时候 we can beRejoice and drink anew with you. 我们可以欢喜快乐和你喝新的那日子。感谢主。Thank you, Lord. 奉耶稣基督的名祷告。In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. 阿门。
Oh.